Coronavirus now. We're following some major headlines this evening. First, the FDA has authorized booster doses of the Moderna and Johnson & Johnson vaccines. The FDA also says adults can mix and match their booster shots. And the White House unveiled its plans to roll out COVID vaccines for young children pending FDA authorization. The distribution plan will target kid-friendly spaces, including schools. Joining us live now with some perspective on all this is Dr. George Rutherford. Thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
So how soon will kids be able to get vaccinated against COVID-19, and when will they really have full immunity?
So I'm guessing the week after next is when this could actually start if all the approvals fall into place. These are Pfizer vaccines, so there's a three-week interval. So if you start on, you know, day zero, then you're out at day 21 and then 14 days. So you'd have immunity by about the 35th day after your first vaccination.
Do you anticipate them having to get booster shots 6 months afterwards as well?
Possibly. I think that probably should be part of the plan.
Okay. And as of course you saw, parents and students held a protest this week against the vaccine mandates in California schools. Some people we spoke to cited the fact that these vaccines are new and they're worried about long-term effects. Well, you're also a pediatrician. What would you tell those parents?
We've given more than 200 million doses in this country, and you know, we have a pretty clear feel for what the side effects are. The other thing, and I don't think people realize, is that the mRNA vaccines, the Pfizer and the Moderna, don't work by going into the nucleus of the cell. They're not picked up into the cell's genetic machinery. They actually work out in the cytoplasm of the cell, where they're just co-opted to make proteins. And so it's not, the chance for genetic manipulation is zero here because the compounds just don't enter the nucleus.
That's just not how these vaccines work. All right, let's talk about boosters now. We've been talking about this, I feel like, with you for a couple months now, this mix and match approach. Originally, they were doing it in Europe. Now it could be a game changer for people who are eligible for these boosters. Right. Should people who got a certain vaccine, though, really try to stick to the same brand if they can?
Yeah, I think that's if we're talking about mRNA vaccines, mm-hmm. Yes. If you got Pfizer, get Pfizer. If you got Moderna, get Moderna. However, they also authorized being able to switch out to an mRNA vaccine, meaning either Moderna or Pfizer for people who got J&J the first time. They also authorized an extra dose of J&J. But if you look at the studies, the boosting that goes on is substantially higher. I mean, substantially higher with... when people who got an original dose of J&J got either Moderna or Pfizer. So it's, this is going to play out over the next week or so. But that's currently what the, you know, recommendations are. The FDA is agnostic, doesn't care whether if you got J&J, whether you get J&J, Pfizer or Moderna. But the data would suggest that you want to get a Moderna or a Pfizer booster.
Right. Stay with the same brand. All right, Dr. Yeah. Rutherford, thank you so much again.
You bet. My pleasure. Take care. Bye-bye.